My VIPs, hey, hello. This is the last episode of Soleil for season one. And I am so excited to do this shit because I'm gonna do a recap of the entire season. I may leave some parts out, I may not. But anyways, we're gonna get into it. This is a screen recording. So I get to go over some of the characters, at least the two main characters, because the others, I'd have to actually play it in order to show you who they are. And I may just stop like the, not stop the video, but you know what I mean. Just tell you each character. But anyways, let's get into it. Here we encounter Tim for the recap. We encounter Tim, our main character, who's late to his class. And he stopped by the hall monitor, Earl. And Earl's just making up nonsense, making Tim even more late. So Tim runs to his class. And we encounter Ezekiel. He runs into Ezekiel. But Ezekiel, honestly, I want to say Ezekiel didn't know where he was going, but honestly, Tim did run into him. We got to admit when we're wrong, fellas. We got to admit when we're wrong. There goes Ezekiel. He's the main love interest. He's into criminology, and he is very new to this campus and university. Little does Tim know, Ezekiel is going to be his new roommate. If I didn't mention already, his old roommate moved out. But anyways, yeah. They have a heated argument. Not really heated. More heated on Tim's side, may I just say. And then Tim makes it to his class, where we encounter Sophie, Norman, and Jay. Ooh, Sophie's the best friend, yes. Norman is very important. He is the president of a club called Rainbow Club, LGBTQ plus community club. And that is Jay, Norman's boyfriend. Norman is hosting a meeting the same day that Tim is late. And that meeting is gonna be important later on because everybody else is late, I think. I believe from my memory, everybody else is late. And Tim comes there at a time where nobody's there and he sees Norman lying on the ground. I'm just gonna show you. So I don't have footage of it because Norman dies on the second episode. Oh my gosh. So you're just gonna see my face as I continue. So fast forwarding, Tim's trying to find out who murdered Norman. And then Tim discovers that Ezekiel is the host of a famous podcast called Soleil, where we get the name for the episode, Soleil. So Tim and Ezekiel go around episode trying to find out who killed Norman. Along the way, we get newer characters. We get Nate. We get, oh, what the hell? Liv and Davey, I forgot their name for a second, who are newer members of the Rainbow Club. Nate is not, but Davey and Liv are. And we have more mess that's going on. We discover Belle and Jesse, who are, they're a-holes, I'm not gonna lie. Bella is an ally, and Jesse is part of the club as well. Yes, her gay best friend, all that. As time goes on, Tim gets drunk off of mushrooms. You know, they try to find out which member of the Rainbow Club is the murderer, because like I said, Norman died by a queer pirate, which is a mascot. They don't know it's a mascot until the, like, literally I think the last two episodes. And so they're trying to see which one of the members killed him, because they were inside the member club's house when Norman died. So we've been doing this wild goose chase, and then we finally discovered two chapters ago, may I say, that it may have been Nate. And Nate's not even part of the Rainbow Club, but Davey is. Davey is a newer member, and she helped Nate, or so we think. We don't know. We're gonna find out in this season one finale of episode Soleil. Chapter 25, The Queer Pirate. Gonna turn this all the way down. Answer, Davey, why did you kill Norman?
What? What? Are you guys serious? I thought you were joking. Or that you were at least smarter than the police. Do you really think I'm a murderer?
What do you mean? Didn't you kill Norman?
No, of course not. I loved him. We were planning to have a life together. I might be a lot of things, but murderer is not one of them. And if you guys couldn't figure it out, I guess I'm really going to prison for a crime I didn't commit.
She's not the murderer? What do you mean? What do you mean, Davey?
Are you stupid or something? I said that I'm not a murderer.
Then why are you in custody right now? Didn't you work with Nate to be the queer pirate?
Okay, it's actually a little more complicated than that.
Damn, bitch, how complicated can this be?
But yes, Nate and I did team up against you.
What the fuck?
It all started the night we celebrated my election as the new president of the Rainbow Club. Oh my gosh, I love that so much in the recap, damn. I had just thrown you out of the Rainbow Club, and when I saw you at the party, I was really mad. Tim, you're here. I didn't think you'd have the nerve to show up during our night out. But little did I know, you also pissed off someone else that night.
Wow, you're so rude. Get lost, man.
And we accidentally met at the bar. Looks like I'm not the only one having a rough night. We both hated you. We both wanted revenge. Bitch, fuck you! No,
bullshit. All this happened way after Norman's murder.
Yes, that's what I'm trying to tell you. Being the pirate was never our plan. We were just haters at that point.
What the fuck? Imagine admitting that you were a hater. Like, bitch, you could go all the way to hell by all we care.
That's when we came up with our first plan to hurt you and separate you.
It didn't work.
We followed Tim and staged the kiss on the cheek. I was the one taking photos, of course.
So Tim didn't see this. Hold on. How the fuck did Tim not see her? How did Tim not see her? She must have been hiding behind something else, but ain't no fucking way you ain't see that. You ain't see Davy.
Okay. No,
Then Nate came up with the Photoshop idea for Zeke.
You're both insane.
Are you sure you can make it look natural?
Please. I studied graphic design. It will look exactly as if Zeke and Norman took that photo together.
I don't know why I do that.
We were preparing to send both photos. But then people started protesting against us because of the podcast.
I'm sorry, my voice is so close to the phone. That's probably why it's so loud.
So we decided to play even dirtier. Look at this. Tim went on that stupid podcast again, and now the whole campus is against my club.
The photos aren't enough, right? We should go even further.
I know. And that same morning, something crazy happened. Nate found the queer pirate's costume in his bedroom.
Huh? Nate found it in his bedroom? Just like that? Who put the queer pirate?
No, we're not doing this. This is insanity. Ain't no fucking way he found that shit in his bedroom. You saying found? That shit wasn't already in his room? Who the fuck put it in his room? If Liv is behind... Y'all don't know who Liv is. I hope y'all know who Liv is, okay? She was a newer member of the... Rainbow Club, I was about to say Queer Pirate Club. Oh my gosh. The Rainbow Club as well, too, alongside Davy. So, Liv is the goth girl, if you haven't seen her already. You're probably going to see her in this episode. If she's behind this, bro, when I see you, Ricky, like, no, when I catch you, Ricky, Nah, I can't. TikTok is absorbing my brain. Anyways, they just found it in his bedroom just like that. That's weird. Keep going. Okay, your story makes no sense. Bitch, we're not gonna... Bitch, I wanna hear more. I don't give a fuck if it don't make sense. Keep going. All right. Let's say this is true. Keep talking.
So we found the costume. How did the pirate costume end up in here? Did you have it the whole time? Did you kill Norman?
No, I didn't. It came in this box, I swear.
That's really weird. But it gave us an idea right away. We were going to pretend to be the pirate to scare the shit out of you.
Ooh, Davy! Hey, my left wrist is ready. My right fist is go.
Oh, wait a minute.
Sneak, we're not gonna sneak you. Gonna hit you so you know.
That's the song I just made up. It was terrible. There goes Liv, her back shot. That, oh my gosh, that is a weird term to use. Oh Lord. But there goes Liv.
So while we were arguing later that day, Nate discreetly sneaked behind your back and slid the note in your backpack. How the fuck did he manage to do that?
Where is y'all spatial awareness, bro? Ezekiel's right behind him. Oh my, I'm so done.
What is this doing in my backpack?
We knew your curiosity would get the best of you and that you would come to the library while Zeke was away. So I dressed as the pirate while Nate was waiting for you.
Tim is here. Go easy on him, okay?
Oh, don't tell me you're starting to appreciate him. Just do as we said and don't forget to turn the lights off. Then, you know, I did my best to terrify you.
Did your best?
You hit us up with a bat and stabbed us. You, oh, you big back bitch. You big back bitch. You ain't shit, bitch.
Damn. And I left the fake photo on purpose to make you think Zeke was the pirate. But obviously our plan failed and you're still talking to each other. Then I realized that Nate was getting a little obsessed over Tim, so I stopped everything.
A little obsessed? He kidnapped Tim with a knife yesterday.
Deadass. Hey, it's not my fault if the guy turned out to be unhinged.
Bitch, y'all both were unhinged, bro.
Why would you team up with a crazy ass dude like this? You stupid. You stupid. You stupid bitch.
Oh my gosh.
The point is, we just wanted to scare you. We didn't kill anyone.
Bitch.
You have to believe me. I don't believe shit you say.
I would never hurt Norman. I would have never hurt Norman. Oh, but you would hurt us? Bitch, I don't give a fuck about Norman no more at this point. It's the fact that you hit him with a bat and then stabbed him. She didn't stab him. She cut him. But bitch, you still draw blood. So we gonna draw blood from you, ho. Messing with my Tim, bro.
My baby? My son? You messing with my son?
Oh my gosh. So do you think she was telling the truth?
It sounded true to me. Yeah.
Fucked up, but true. Then the wrong people are behind bars once again. They still broke the law, Tim. Both Davey and Nate deserve to be in custody.
Yes, but not for being killers. The real queer pirate is still out there. And now they are most likely about to get away with murder.
Not necessarily. There is one last lead we didn't fully pursue. We don't know who Bend Over is. This Bend Over. Oh my gosh. It was one of the leads that Ezekiel had in the last episode. Anyways, one of the people that's living in town. But I still have their address.
I guess it's worth giving it a try, right?
Of course it is. Let's complete this investigation and go full circle to have a clear conscience. And if we find out something new, it can only help.
You're absolutely right. So what's the plan? My air is on in the back. If y'all probably already knew that shit. Oh my gosh, I'm just saying random shit. We pay them a visit, of course.
My bad.
According to maps, it should be this house. Let's discover who Bend Over is.
What if nobody's home?
Oh, Tim, do you even have to ask by now?
He's gonna break in his fucking house.
Oh my gosh, I love Ezekiel, bro. I actually love Ezekiel, bro.
At first, I was like, ooh, he's giving me a ooh before it ever rod. Like, did us.
But he's giving me a ah before it ever ooh. Why I say it like that? Oh my gosh. But nah, I was very skeptical of Ezekiel because he a little too okay with breaking into people's shit. So it's like, it's making me wonder. Like, the only one who's ever confirmed to be a criminal is Liv. Even though she's not really a criminal, but she's admitted to stealing. Like, she likes stealing. She dead ass told two people she likes stealing. So, Ezekiel, you just like breaking into people's shit?
If no one's home, then we're breaking and entering. Of course. Yo, Ezekiel, something different. Please be home. Please, please be home. Please, please, please be home.
Looks like nobody's home.
Oh my gosh, Zeke.
Breaking and entering it is.
Ain't no way. Zeke, don't yell that in public. Jeez.
Oh my god. Oh my gosh. I'm too excited. I'm shaking the fucking table. I'm shaking my table here. Come on. Let's find a way in.
I bet you $10 the back door is open. You are too excited for this, Zeke.
If Ezekiel is the queer pirate, oh my gosh.
If Ezekiel is the queer pirate, bro, we are on everything. If Ezekiel is the queer pirate, bro, hold on, you gonna see me.
Oh God, if Ezekiel is the fucking queer pirate, I'm really finna go, I'm a bat at his head, dead ass. If Ezekiel is the queer pirate, bro, Ricky, when I catch you, Ricky. My glasses falling off. When I catch you, Ricky. Oh my gosh.
Back door. Bad idea.
I bet it's locked. Nah, bitch. Are we really gonna bet money? I'm broke. I can't afford coffee at Insomniac Cookies. I'm broke.
I don't even think they sell coffee.
No, because they have a place called Insomnia? I don't fucking know. It says it in the world, okay? I bet it's locked. And I bet you $10 it's locked.
It was open. You owe me $10. I owe you shit. I owe you shit, Ezekiel. I'll give you a kiss.
You might maybe possibly could grab up my ass. But anyways.
Alright, you won. Now let's figure out who lives here and get the hell out.
The bedroom. Let's see if we can find anything in here.
Hey, what if it's no one we know? Have you thought about that?
Come on, we know this person is linked to the Rainbow Club. This person has to be connected to us somehow. Y'all think I'm getting sick. I walked out in the rain 3 times today. I had to go to class. But anyways, that's so fucking random. What that got to do with the story, girl? I almost said my real name, damn. What that got to do with the story, A-list? Shit. What are we even looking for? Something like, oh. Like this, I guess. Are we in Nate's house? Handcuffs? Zeke, how is that a clue? Well, it tells us one thing about Bend Over. He's kinky. Zeke, do you want to add that to our routine, bitch? Do you want that add that to the bedroom, sir? Nah, you can. Oh my gosh. It's kinky. Should I laugh? Tim has really changed since chapter one. Tim would have been like, bitch, and then swung at his head. Like, nah. No, he actually would. But still, nah, Tim is a different dude now. Honestly, let's laugh. Let's laugh. He's trying to impress us. Oh, yes. It's funny. Fucking Richmond's laugh. I love it. All right, Mr. Funny. Let's focus on real clues. How are them not real clues? They belong to our last suspect, so they tell us something about them. So, have you ever been handcuffed? Want to try them on? Stop it, Zeke. We're on an investigation. Ooh, stop. Zeke knows he's top. He don't give a fuck at this point. He's just like, hey, you know, want me to cuff you down so I can really do something dirty to you? Zeke, we are in somebody's house that is not ours. And that is not our own. Zeke, don't even touch those. Hey, do you see that? What are those stains? Zeke, don't touch them. It's nasty. No, look closer. There's something on them. Some dry, orange, mushy substance. Ew. It's not blood. Blood doesn't turn orange and mushy. That's something else entirely. Right, I see it. It looks like spray tan. Is our teacher the queer pirate? Bro, because I don't know who else has a dog named Giselle. Wait! Is it the policeman?
I got you, kiddo.
Is it him? Is it him? Because he's the only one that's orange. Bitch. Oh, is he Bend Over? I think it said it in the... No, I think his name is Thomas. Who the fuck is Bend Over? Okay. Grr. Ew, what's that crusty old dog? Tim, we've seen this dog before. You're right. I remember seeing this dying pooch somewhere. Don't say that. Oh my, of course. Zeke, this is Officer Lobster's dog. It was on his lock screen.
Bitch, it's over, kiddo.
It's him. Oh my gosh, it's him. Bro, spray tan, bro. Officer Donald Trump is the fucking queer pirate. No, he's Bend Over, but still. That's it, we're in his house. The dog is our evidence.
I think there's even bigger evidence than spray tan and the dog, Tim. Look above the bed.
Oh my, that's him and some other guy. We're in Officer Lobster's house.
Yes, I think Bend Over is Officer Lobster. He's the pirate. Okay, let's take photos and leave.
Fuck! Oh my gosh,
put that phone away now before I shoot you.
All right, no need to pull a gun.
My neighbor had called me saying 2 boys were sneaking around my house. Of course it's you two. You keep sticking your nose where it doesn't belong.
We were just about to leave. You're not going anywhere. Now you know too much. Really, we don't know that much. Tim is right. I almost said time. Oh my gosh, I did say time. Tim is right, we don't know much. So why don't you start by telling us why you killed Norman?
Ezekiel!
Yo! Ezekiel, we're finna fucking die. What are you doing? Did you call somebody? Please tell me you called somebody. Right, Bend Over. Ezekiel. Oh my gosh.
How? Where did you hear that name?
We went to the university's storage to figure out who borrowed the pirate costume. But Bend Over? Really? What kind of alias is that?
What do you mean, alias? Bend Over is my real name.
I fucking knew it.
No!
Y'all ain't shit for real. This nigga's holding y'all at gunpoint. Y'all decided to laugh. That's why y'all gonna get... That blicky is really heated now. Y'all gonna get shot for real. Don't do that. Your real name is Denover? Yeah, right. That's hilarious.
Hey, stop laughing. I'm still holding a gun.
Oh, you're not kidding. Why do they call you Officer Matthews then?
Matthews was my late husband's last name. That's him on the photo. He died last year, heart attack. Now it's just me and Giselle.
Is she okay?
She's fine. It's just her asthma and arthritis acting. Damn, how old is she?
No, she got arthritis and asthma? Oh my gosh. Oh, that's not funny. Can we focus back on the case? How did you know about the costume?
Well, if you find it, I'm sure you know about Captain O'Rainbow.
We do. The question is, how do you know about it?
I know about it because I am Captain O'Rainbow. Oh my gosh.
What? You were part of the Rainbow Club?
Yes, I was one of its first members back when I was a student. These were very different times, of course. Gay rights were barely even existing at the time. That's why we created the club.
To help. Oh my God, fuck. I know it's a mistake. I'm sorry. Don't bash me. To help build a community for people like us on campus. No offense, but that was probably decades ago. Norman was not even born. Legally, he knows.
Of course he wasn't. We wouldn't have never let such a spoiled brat become president of the club at the time.
Ha. So you do know him.
How? All right, I'll give it to you. You two are good. You'd make good detectives. See, when my husband died and I had to take care of sick Giselle, I realized I wasn't happy with my life anymore. I'm an underpaid cop in a precinct with no budget. It got me thinking. When was the last time I was actually useful and happy?
Please do not tell me you slept with Norman. Bro, if y'all are new to this, I hope you're not. But Norman got around. Like, he was president of the Rainbow Club, the gay club. Well, I say gay club. In fact, it's LGBTQ plus club. Sorry for saying that. But, yeah, he was bisexual. He had a boyfriend, Jay. And may I just tell you, he was a hoe. He got around too many people, and he would record his sexual experiences with those people. So he was a weirdo, okay? But he was also very social. So that's the one who died, Norman. The very social, bisexual hoe. Yeah, it was very, very social, bisexual hoe. That sounds so bad. Oh, my God. Anyways.
I see. Typical midlife crisis. Hey, don't call me old, you little prick.
You are old.
I just wanted to feel happy again. To be Captain O'Rainbow again.
Arr! Ahoy! Heave homophobia! Gays will crush ye barnacles and shiver ye timber for equality.
Yes. He did your big one. Okay, Mr. Lobster. Mr. Bend Over. Okay. It was just me. The only time I ever remembered being happy without my husband.
And let me guess, you wanted back into the Rainbow Club, so you went to Norman.
Yes, I did. I wanted to bring the pirate back. But guess what his reaction was?
Listen, this is an elite LGBTQIA plus group. Not a carnival version of Captain Hook. No, because I don't think I ever did a voice for Norman, like an actual voice for Norman, but I feel like he just sounds like a rich white kid. Like, he probably just sounds like that.
But I was one of the founding members. I protested with this costume. We fought for gay rights on campus.
Well, thanks for your service, old man. But we don't need a pathetic fossil dressed as a pirate around here. Yo, fuck you, Norman, bro. I see why he stabbed your ass.
Damn. Fuck you, bitch. Still he did. The Rainbow Club would be nowhere without me. And he called me old.
You are old. It's okay. Accept it. You have greater white hair. You put spray tan on because you can't stand the fact that you're old. Like, deadass. You got wrinkles on your forehead. You're old, sir. Now, hey, that doesn't mean you're not still good looking, mister, okay? You really snatch you snatch everybody up with dumb looks, baby. Just stop with the orange, okay? Too much orange. You're gonna get skin cancer, sir. Like, damn.
I fought for gay rights. I did everything for your generation to have more freedom than mine. It was always a struggle. It was never so easy for us to be gay.
Wait a second. Is that why you have rainbows on your face? Faces? You know, back in my days, queer people didn't impose their lifestyle on everyone else.
It all makes sense now.
You were jealous. Deadass. Jealous? No, I wasn't jealous. I was hurt and offended. After all I did for the club and the community back in my days, that's the thanks I get? That smug fucker looked that smug fucker looked in my face and called me pathetic.
Smug? Fucker? Wait. You're the one who was threatening Norman by text, am I right?
Yes, it was me. But threatening him wasn't enough. I had to make him pay.
You actually murdered this dude?
You could have just beat him up, like deadass.
But no, Norman knew that he was queer pirate, so he couldn't have beaten him up.
This was so honest. You couldn't have snuck him?
Hey, Norman would have never known. Getting beat up is what Norman deserves. By, and I mean beat up, not jumped, but beat up by, individually, by all the people he had recorded while he had screwed them, had sex with them. So that's the ones who deserve to beat him up. Not some old ass man who was jealous of the younger generation. Like, dead ass. It's like, all he wanted to do was be part of the Rainbow Club again, which is honestly, like, I understand. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. It's just that you got so mad at some rich white boy telling you that you're pathetic for wanting to relive your past again to the point to where you murdered him. You should have been like, fuck you, bitch. And then went to the, like, headmaster. Like, he's president of the Rainbow Club, but it's not like he owned, it's not like the club is completely run by Norman. Like, oh yeah, he's the founding creator, so everything that says goes to him. Like, you could have went to the higher ups about it. Because, like, yeah, y'all found the club, but isn't it that clubs can't get the say-so unless it's said by, like, a minister or somebody higher up? I don't know. I've never created a club at a school before. So, yeah. Please, don't do this. Psh, now, who's pathetic? Eh? That's why the pirate was always one step ahead. You're in charge of the investigation. You know how the Rainbow Club works.
Yes, indeed. But it didn't have to be so complicated. That first homophobic weirdo could have stayed in jail, but you proved him innocent.
Damn. So he was actually, that's why he was so ready to arrest that homophobic weirdo, because then it could all be over.
And you just had to keep digging and give me more work. So I tried to silence you, but you wouldn't even let me do that. You started investigating, snooping around everywhere. I tried scaring you off, making you stop, but you never got the message.
Listen, you won't get away with this, so please just let us go.
Why wouldn't I get away with this? I don't have the costume. It was in Nate's room.
You planted it there, didn't you? How did you know him and Davey would take the bait?
I was supervising the protest on campus, and I overheard them.
We should go even further.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. I delivered the pirate costume to Nate's bedroom, and they did the rest by themselves. I let them do it, of course. Little did they know, they helped me get away with murder.
So they weren't lying. The costumes really came out of nowhere.
Indeed, but who will believe their story anyway? It makes absolutely no sense. It makes absolutely no sense. Besides, they are already in jail, and they will be declared guilty. I will make sure of it.
No, we won't let you do that.
Oh, and how exactly will you stop me? You broke into my house. My neighbor saw you. I came home, surprised you as you were stealing. Then you attacked me. Boom, two bullets, self-defense. You're dead. I win.
Oh no, is this the end? Is this the way I die? Do gunshots hurt, bitch?
Tim, nah, gunshots don't hurt, bitch. Nah, they feel like nothing. In fact, nah, they just feel like a tickle. A tickle, yes, that you feel all throughout your body. A tickle, yes. It feel like a warm, cuddly hug. A cool hot cocoa in a summer's eve. That don't make no sense.
Tim, the dog. Oh my gosh, they're gonna kill the dog. They're gonna kill Giselle.
What about that poor dying thing? What about that poor dying thing?
Grab the doll now.
Why would I do that? What are you two whispering? Stop doing that.
Tim, now.
All right.
No, what are you doing? We're gonna kill your fucking dog. Put your gun away now. Giselle! Please, please don't hurt her. She's all I have left. Zeke, why am I holding this old, shitty, smelly dog? Then to let us go or he will kill her. I'm sorry, this is such an intense moment, but I can't get over the fact that this dog is dying. This is so sad. Oh my gosh. Wait, no! I'm not killing a dog. He will kill your little dying rat. I swear. No, Ezekiel, you should have held that fucking dog. Tim is not going to kill this fucking rat. I mean, this dog. I'm sorry. He's not going to put it out his misery. You two are monsters. Sir, I would never hurt your dog. Tim, shut up. Or he will. Let us go, lobster. Oh my gosh. Zeke, you're being insane and scary. Fine. Give me the damn thing. Zeke! Hey, bend over. Do you want your prehistorical dog back? Then catch it. Oh my poor Giselle. You're okay. You're okay with daddy. Bork. Damn. You dropped your gun. This game is over, queer pirate. Crap. Yo, Zeke is a fucking hero. I love him. Yo, Tim, what the hell? You ain't understood the assignment whatsoever, bitch. Talk about, I'm not gonna kill it. Tim, you may just have to. Deadass, you may just have to kill the fucking thing. I'm just gonna be honest with you, baby. It's okay. In fact, don't kill it. Instead, hold its neck. Actually, no way. He would have probably killed it on accident. I don't know. I don't know what Tim could have done. Fuck. Shit. Anyways, Ben Matthews, you're under arrest. You have nothing against me. I'll be out in no time, say. Actually, we found traces of spray tan on the queer pirate's mask. Bet it would match yours. Oh no. I can't believe this is happening. I would have gotten away with it if it hadn't been for you two meddling gay kids. Aw. I wonder how long your fake tan will last in prison. Oh, you little. Thank you for calling the police, boys. We'll take it from here. Tim, we caught him. We caught the queer pirate. Can you believe it? Bitch, you caught the queer pirate. Hey, Tim ain't do shit. I'm not gonna lie. We held that dying ass dog. And we said, nah, we not gonna kill it. We not gonna kill it, baby. Tim ain't do shit. Well, actually, he did do something. But he ain't do it officially. You have to pretend like you are gonna do the damn thing. Okay, Tim? You ain't know the assignment whatsoever. In fact, you did know it. But you actively went against it. So it's like, damn, bitch, you wanted to fail. So it's like, wow. Actually, I can't say I do. I mean, we spent so much time on this case. And now it's over? I mean, do you want it to keep going? Hey, you've literally been chased how many times by a queer pirate? Why do you want to keep it going? Oh, it's not over yet, Tim. You're forgetting something very important. Really? What is it? Come on. We have one final episode of Slay to record and put on the podcast together. Ooh! One last kiss, please. Please, one last kiss. It turns out the pirate was created for all the right reasons. But he destroyed all the good he had worked for in the name of resentment. And while we learned that Norman was indeed rather mean and narcissistic, he did not deserve to be. Geez, Zeke. Do I really have to use that word? Come on. It's the last episode. You have to say it. He didn't deserve to be slayed. I will end this shit right the fuck now. There is no outro. We're just done. Like that. I will end this shit right now. But in the end, the queer pirate was apprehended by the authorities. So we can all sleep safe and sound again. That was Slay. Thank you for listening. See you next season for a new queer murder to solve. Ooh, yes. Yes, baby. And cut. That was amazing. Wow. It feels weird, doesn't it? It's like we just got rid of our biggest hobby. You bitches ain't shit. You want to keep getting chased by this fucking murderer? Like, I don't know. What are we even going to talk about now? your separate interests. You're literally dating your boyfriends. You've literally done the dude, the dirty tangle. You know, hey, you done broke each other's backs. I mean, what the fuck else is there to talk about? Like, of course there's more to talk about than just this shit. Tim, oh my gosh. I can't. Please. Even though you don't like to admit this, you and I have a lot in common. And maybe you like to keep working with me on the podcast. We would have to find a new case for that. Well, the world is full of criminals and we're still roommates. So I'm sure we can find some time for this, right? Aw. Ooh, the wing. Ah, I'll take another kiss. But in the meantime, I think we both deserve a break from all the morbidness. Yeah, that we can both agree on. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. How would you like to have some fun? As long as it doesn't involve dealing with a brutal murderer, I'm in. Oh! I promise there will be no murderer involved. But I can't promise it won't be brutal.
Ooh! Okay.
No, sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm actually not. Oh, is that the end? Oh, bitch, they really had us for real. A few months later. All right. Everyone's here. It's been a few months since the pirate was arrested. No one is talking shit about the Rainbow Club anymore. And we haven't received a death threat in 2 weeks. Yeah. Also, as your brand new club president, period, Travis, yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Whoa, wait. Oh, my gosh. Wait a minute. I forgot Travis. Yes, you did. Yes, royalty. Yes, royalty. Yes. I'm going to just do that. I'm sorry. I did not mean to misgender Travis. I actually forget some of the characters' orientations when it comes to this, because it doesn't really make it a big deal when it comes to their characters. So, well, it does, but it doesn't at the same time. So it's hard. And it was like around the middle of the episode. So, yeah. Anyways, I should inform you. We are going to welcome some new students to our group tonight. So I hope everything is ready for our comeback party.
Everything is in place. It will be an incredible party.
I know we didn't talk dress code, but you should know I will be serving tonight.
Bella, she shouldn't be part of this club. She literally drugged Tim with shrooms. And shrooms ain't drugs, or I don't know who labels it as. But he has never had shrooms before. And this motherfucker was in the woods naked. Butt booty ass naked. Like, of course, episode's not going to show his junk. But, hey, Tim ain't had no clothes on. So, this bitch shouldn't still be here.
Ditto. Great. See you all tonight, then.
Seeing all of us back together, still standing after what happened, it actually makes me feel happy. This might be the only good outcome we have from the Crow Pirate. He made us stick together because at the end of the day, we're all part of the same community. And somehow, I can't help but think it feels good to be back to normal. Except, normal never lasts for too long around here. Before you know it, someone else's blood might already be spilled all over the floor.
Zeke, she's dead. Do you see that? She's dead.
Tim, take a deep breath. Let's call the police.
We have to call off the party first. The guests could arrive any time now. Tim, fuck the party. There's a dead girl in here.
It's the second murder that happens in this room this year alone. See, we're right back to normal. The good news is, I guess we just found a new topic for our next season of Slay.
Bitch, that was morbid. Wait a minute. You just go.
Hold on.
The second season of Slay is coming, so keep an eye out for it.
Hey. That was a little too much. You did not need to end it like that.
Zeke, she's dead.
Who? Which one? Is it someone? Which one? I was about to be like, is it someone from our club already presently? Or is it someone new? And they said she.
Who is it?
Who is it? Like, if it's so, it's not Sophie, because if it were Sophie, Tim would be having a fit. He would be going literally in fucking sane, okay? Okay, so it's not Sophie. I'm so happy. Can't be Mina. Fuck it.
Yeah, you're welcome, baby. Thank you for making this. Oh my gosh. See you soon, Slay Tip Jai. Period. We too big. Are you serious? No, I'm just kidding. If you enjoy what we anyways, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Y'all. That was the end. 40 minutes, bro. I don't know why I took a picture. 40 minutes, bro. Of season one, bro. And there's more. Of course, there's more. Another person's dead. They said she. Who the fuck is it? I don't know. But what I'm excited for is more Slay. I should go back and redo some of the episodes. As in, I should quite literally actually do episode 2 through 10, by the way. Because I don't have those episodes. I don't actually know where they are. But... Baby, I am so fucking happy I did this. This was fucking great. I'm so happy. I am so happy. Thank y'all all for watching. I love y'all. I adore y'all. I'm so happy y'all actually wanted this, bro. Because every time I did the episode, I was just like, man, not many people are watching it. But I don't give a fuck. I'm still going to issue out some episodes, baby. But still, this was the season. Oh my gosh. This was season one finale of Slay. Thank y'all for watching, and may peace be with you for an eternity.